Stop.
You m- Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala. This public service announcement for anger management brought to you by Tampax.
Good morning, coffee drinkers. It is groove day here at the Gwizdala household. And that is what my day's looking like. This groove and probably a bunch of other grooves. And I'm gonna do a little Facebook live streaming right now. And I'm thinking of working on a new course for VBL called Art of the Groove and working on how to improvise in the context of a bass line and be super musical, super supportive, very melodic and very creative and still perform the traditional role of a bass player without stepping on people's toes. I think when you listen to a player, maybe like a Pino Palladino, he seems to be able to find a beautiful way of being incredibly musical, creative, melodic, and developmental in his bass lines while he's accompanying great singers and great artists. So that's what I'm working on today, groove playing. It's never the wrong time to not play up the dusty end and to actually play in the fundamentals of the instrument. And that is what is happening today. So it's good to keep the fingers loose on both ends of the instrument, I think. Sometimes I don't spend as much time in the low end as I should. Sometimes I don't spend as much in the high end as I should. It's good to make that balance. Good to do a nice little groove session. I've still got my pajamas on. It's the morning here. Well, it's almost not the morning. But there's never a wrong time for either, I don't think. Out of the groove stuff, I kind of have some melodic ideas now as well, so. So so I should probably do my metronome bit, although the phone that's doing the Facebook Live thing is the metronome.
This is a way better view than me sitting here playing bass lines. Yeah, we just had a fun dinner with my buddy Eric from Sydney. Australia and New Zealand taking shape. We're getting excited about that. Chelsea is coming with me. Yeah, that's excitement. So yeah, today was a bit of a groove day, huh? Just got in the pocket and kept going, didn't stop. So here's the question, here's the million-dollar question, is what would you want to hear about groove playing in a series of videos? Something, what did I say, the art of the groove or something like that. Somebody probably has the art of the groove. It's too good a name not to have been used already, but like freedom in the groove or something like that, freedom of groove. I just want to be able to highlight the fact that you can be melodic and creative and develop motifs and be artistic and still be a foundational player in a band. And I think that's what, like when I listen to Pino, I get that. You know what I mean? He's the dude. Like he plays a lot of stuff. If it wasn't melodic and it wasn't, you know, appropriate, you might say he was overplaying.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Totally.
Who else do you like?
Am I allowed to answer that?
Yeah, of course you are.
You?
No, you're not allowed to answer it.
Really? Okay, so Janek is an amazing solo bass player, but the reason that I liked his playing in the first place was 100% because of the groove. He has the most tasteful licks that he throws in. You know, that's the thing about bass players. The time that they get to show off is when they get to throw their little lick in between whatever part of the groove they actually have to play. And it just turns into gospel chops sometimes, and it is so not musical and not tasteful, and man, Janek's are insane.
I appreciate the compliment. You told me what?
The moment that the first night that we ever went on a date.
Oh yeah.
Was his bass bash. And he played this one lick with Tense. And I was like, that was the moment that you had me.
Wow.
You didn't have to do anything.
Okay, so the very first exercise in my new chord book apparently gets you a super hot day.
But that's what I'm saying. It's so simple, it's okay. Musical, it's tasteful.
I do get that. And it's about like the social element of it,
mm-hmm.
in so many ways, like making people dance. Like, mm-hmm. That's what music's for, right? Isn't like percussion the root of all music?
Yep.
Right? And then when we get into the bass that combines a lot of percussion and then harmony as well, we can do so much. And trust me, I do a lot. Like, I play a lot of notes a lot of the time. But like Chelsea's saying, like, she's giving me a very beautiful compliment. That's awesome. I appreciate that. But on the real side, like, that should be what we're all doing all of the time.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're not, even, that's the other thing. Like, when I'm playing a solo show and when I'm playing up the dusty end of the neck, I'm playing all these notes and flying around, I still have the mindset of when I'm playing like a 3-chord tune on an R&B gig. It may be a little more dense, a little more verbose at times, but I'm still trying to be appropriate, socially appropriate. Socially appropriate bass playing, jeez.
I have another one if you want me.
Tell me.
Ethan Farmer.
Ethan Farmer, okay, tell
me. I had never heard a bass player who, kind of like Pino, like he can play so many notes, but I'd never heard harmony and melody outlined so beautifully than when he was being a sideman. But you could hear everything that was going on
right.
in the song in his bass lines.
Plus, he has a super amazing sound, I think.
Completely.
And it's really clear. Like, he fits. I think what I appreciate about Ethan so much is, A, he's kind of a big Pat Metheny fan. Which
I
think so, yeah. I've heard him playing some Pat Metheny too, but just that he's a fan of that style of music,
mm-hmm.
which that's where the melody, I think, a lot of his melody comes from. I know it's where a lot
totally.
Of mine comes from, that jazz and improvised element. But what I appreciate about Ethan is the fact that he knows where the bass fits in a mix.
Exactly.
He has so much experience of where the place is, and I'm talking about gigahertz here, or megahertz, or whatever they are, hertz, probably hertz, right? Down there, you know, like, he really knows how to mix the bass in the mix in a live setting. Of course, in the studio as well, he plays on tons of records, but I really appreciate that about him. And I think I appreciate that the most about all bass players that I like,
mm-hmm.
possibly all musicians that I like. Because they really understand their place in the mix.
Yes.
Okay, we got way off the groove here and went into other stuff, but that's kind of where today was sitting for me. Definitely in the pocket, or at least trying to be, and working on some things. Give me some feedback. If you could pick apart all the things I played today,
what questions would you ask about them? And when you come up with those questions, I can form videos about them and answer them and put them into nice courses and organize them and possibly make a groove book out of it. We've got like 8 books on the griddle right now. This could be it. Art of the Groove. That might be the Christmas book.
Oh, we already have 2 other Christmas books.
Well, there could be a competition here for Christmas. We might just do 1 book at Christmas and we'll see which one fights the hardest.
I think Art of the Groove should be the next Bass Player's Guide to the Galaxy book.
Oh, that's right.
That's a good one for the series.
Okay, so Bass Player's Guide to the Galaxy, the next thing should be Art of the Groove. Let's work on that, and your guys' feedback is essential in the success of that. So let me know. Comments below. Today's vlog is done, and we will see you guys tomorrow.
You're so creepy. Stop!
Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala. This is a public service announcement for anger management brought to you by Tampax.